Sentences about Orna's background, because she will not tell you that. This is her fourth solo exhibition with me, and that means a lot, and her work has developed incredibly. And she does have some very important accomplishments to herself, one of them being solo exhibition at the Museum of Printing History. It was an incredible exhibit of about 100 pieces or so, almost. And several shows at the International Print Center in New York City with the blue chip name artists that I don't even name right now. And the main thing is that at the moment, she's very sought after. Her work is very exciting and is going in a beautiful direction. She's widely collected, and she will be kind enough to show you what really means to do the monoprinting. This is a very original technique of hers that there is monoprinting that's been done, but no one, to my knowledge, is doing what she's doing. And after a very short presentation, she will do the gallery walk and sort of tell you more about each piece, what it is exactly, and how they came about to be who they are. So that's fine. Then we'll have questions if anyone wants to ask or not. And one more thing I would like to mention, that should you have any interest in purchasing any of her works, we are donating 50% to, what is it, JCC? Tonight's sales.
Thank you.
So, Orna.
Okay. Thank you for coming. I know many of you asked me before, how do I make my work? And many of you saw my big press, but never saw me working. So, tonight you have a chance to understand a little bit how the process is done. So, everything that I make goes through the pressure of the press. Nothing is done directly on the surface. In this case, I have papers, fabrics, and plexiglass, which all of them went through this roller here. So the press weighs 2 tons, that's why we can bring it with me today. So I bought the picture, and we have a flat bed where I put the papers and the plexiglass, and the roller in there, and when I turn the wheel, the flat bed goes under the roller to the other side, and then I can lift the blankets and see the work underneath. I'll demonstrate how a frame is done to understand the process, how it's done. So this is, for example, a very simple print that I created from the demonstration purposes. You can see that there are several elements and different colors. Each color is run through the press separately. So for this one, I start with a plexiglass that is clear and that I can reuse. So I cut the plexiglass, and for this print, I ran a yellow coat over the plexiglass, and the two little trays are prayers. And I spread the ink, mix the colors on the table, and then roll it and ink the plates. So the first layer, I put this over the bed of the press, and I put the paper over it. And of course, cover it with blankets so it doesn't break, because this is metal, two metals, so if I don't cover, protect it, it will break. Then it goes under the press, and when it comes on the other side, I lift it and the yellow is on the paper. Then I clean up the plate and I can reuse it for a different color and a different layer. The second layer, I did a half of it in blue and removed some pattern that I would like to create. And put it again on the press and cover it with the paper, the same paper, I have this already, this and roll the wheel and come to the other side like this. So now we can see that I printed in blue, but I did get in green because I printed all the yellow. So this is something that I need to take into consideration when I work, because things I might want one color and I need different colors. So I need to kind of more or less plan how I build up the layers. The third layer.
The color will be based on the color.
That complicated to match the image if I want to overlay one on top of the other. But if I want to do a text, or if, for example, I wanted this for this, you know, I always have to be conscientious about the orientation of the plate. Sometimes I make a plate print and then I reverse the paper and then it goes in a different location. So this is something else that printmaking you have to think about. The last layer that I did here is a drawing, and the way I did that is my process that is called, it's like an ethnography. It's a plan that I can Xerox the images from my drawing book and bake it, and then I can ink the image. It's a different complicated process. But then I put it all of this and press, and the image gets transferred. So basically, I can use images. Sometimes I can repeat the image, but in the monoprint, the whole thing is done only one time. Since nothing is fixed on the plate, every time I clean it, I have to start from the beginning. So each time that I print, the color is different, the order of the layers of the color is different. I sometimes print on this line. So it's like endless. It's very hard to repeat the same print, to duplicate. It's impossible to duplicate. I can do similar, but never duplicate because of the color combination and also the pressure. Every time that I work, you know, even though I may write, you know, the pressure on 3.5, the next time it doesn't work. I need more pressure or less pressure. I don't know, somebody new in my studio changing things overnight, I don't know. Never happens if I can repeat that. So now I'll tell you what are my innovations in the field that, as far as Anya and I know, nobody else is working like me. And several years ago, actually in the beginning, when I started to print, I said, this is such an old technique to use this press. Printmaking is a process that's available to artists for hundreds of years, and I'm so contemporary in my thinking that I just didn't like the idea that I'm using the same tools and machines that people used 400, 500 years ago. So I have to make it contemporary, make it something that's of today's sensibilities. I said, I'm going to invent something. So several years ago, I started to develop I'm printing now for almost 11 years. And I did traditional printmaking on paper, just the ink on paper. And about 2-3 years ago, I developed interest in dimensional. And I said, I'm going to create this into something that's more dimensional. So actually, the beginning of the dimensionality came, I think, last show, when I started to collage paper over the paper, and it was more dimensional. It was get some volume patterns. And then I still share ideas of putting layers. Instead of putting the layers right on the paper, I'm putting on the layers of the material to see who it is there. But the end result is that when you look at the marriage between the material and the image, it's so good that you don't really know what was what. You just look like, you know, it looks complete. And that's a big challenge. I mean, other than the material, so the material doesn't take the color the same way material stretches, shrinks, and frames, you make it. So, and also I have to find material that works for the theme. So I love the challenge. It actually gets me maybe four times more to make these things than the ones in one fabric. Even though it's only one layer of fabric, it's four times more time. So it's extremely labor intensive. Also, in these new planes, you can see that the dimensions are really big. For a plane, it's really big. Things are really small. I have even more challenge myself than this one because the surface of the print is larger than my press area. So that's another challenge that I have to deal with. So after working with the families, I said, maybe I can make the distance between the material even larger. So I said, okay, I'm going to print in place it as it said, because then I can have an inch or 2 inches or 3 inches between the surfaces and create even more depth. And then I moved to this print and printed on the paper and then spaced it in a way that I create movement. So I now can walk around the piece that looks different from every angle. So I achieve another layer. And there I have that, and here I also have the movement. I have to move and see it differently. So after I did that, I said, well, if I build the print on two plexiglass, and make it round and turn it, then I don't have to move, I can just move the piece and create different looks when I do it. Also, when I do it like this, I create shadows that don't exist on the other pieces that create a lot more interest in another element going on there.
So this is
No, the paper and plexiglass.
Okay, it's paper and plexiglass. So it's layers of print on the paper.
On the paper and the layers of
the
Yes, yes. So how I do that, of course. That's the
idea.
That's why I print, especially you see in the show that I'm working on the same thing. Those of you who know me know that I've been doing it since 97. I'm still doing the tree trunk and the reins, but it's all new materials and different looks and different effects that I get it, the same thing. So I benefit a lot from print reading because I don't have to every time do the same drawing and spend time on what's not important. I don't need to reach all the same lines, but I want to get the effect that it doesn't. No, I work because the process is such that I work in layers and because it's oil based, it takes time to dry. So it depends. If I want the piece, if I want the second layer to go wet on wet, still wet, then I go the next day with the second color. But normally I like to go wet on dry. So let me just stay on. So it makes sense to work on a lot of pieces at the same time. And so I'm working on dozens of pieces at the same time. Each one sits and waits for the next layer.
So when you start to develop a piece, would you visualize?
No, not at all. Exactly, as I go. And because I work intuitive and I know more or less what I want, but I don't have the same vision. And that's also the beauty of printmaking, is that it's element of surprise in the air. Because of the pressure and the change of the color.
Yeah.
That's what I like about it. I have surprises. I want surprises. I want to deal with things as they come. calm enough to plan and do it. I've done this before, it's boring. It just works. If you have an idea and you just do it, it just works. But here it's more play for me. I have more work and I'm always flexible to change it. It's the result. If something happens, you just need to go in a different way. So
yes, it's just like that. Having a CD and say that express something. Say this, to put it in the day and say, yeah, that's something I want to do. Not something in the beginning, so I wanted to do.
Why? Yeah, it's never like that.